What's going on, everyone? Talon back here, and today we are going to be going over some official news, some 95% official news, I guess, and we're going to talk about them for a little bit because everyone's flipping out about this stuff, and I know technically this is actually considered old news. It was mentioned like over a month ago or something like that, but no one really believed it. And then more kind of information and kind of hints came out about it, and I was just like, okay, maybe this is gonna happen. And now we're getting even more proof about this, and it's just like, okay, well, I guess I'll make a video on it. So people stop asking me to make a video on it. So it is what it is. But anyway, so first off, official news. Like this right here is official, as you can clearly see. This is on the official Dokkan Twitter page, okay? So there's gonna be a mandatory maintenance from 8 a.m. Japan time until 4 p.m. Japan time tomorrow, or by the time most of you are watching this, it's already gonna be Wednesday, but again, not until 8 p.m. or 8 a.m. Japan time, okay? And we've saw some of the previews for this in the official Twitter page as well. I mean, if you actually go onto their official Twitter page and you scroll down a little bit, you're gonna find all of these, not that stuff. This is all the banner stuff that just came out. Okay, where are you? Here we are. So, like, we have the fact that we're getting this little Hercule button and everything like that to just, you know, take all your Hercule statues all at once, which is pretty nice. We're getting some more options for reversing your characters from just the character tab, and then you can go ahead and select your characters a little bit better or be able to organize them a little bit better in Dokkan Battlefield. And then finally, in the Baba Shop, you'll be able to swipe, you know, swipe over, essentially. So, and then supposedly as well, there is supposed to be some new animations coming. A lot of people are thinking that this is going to be the Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Goku that has been in the files for who knows how long. We haven't never seen the actual summon animation for quite a while. So we don't know if that's going to happen. We don't know if there's going to be maybe like a Family Kamehameha trio or something like that. And they're going to add new trios in for indicating, oh, you are automatically going to get a featured unit. Oh, you are automatically going to get the featured unit that is new to the banner. Kind of like how Legends does it. You know that if you get the Bardock animation or the Trunks animation, then you are guaranteed to get one of the new Sparky units. Whereas if you just simply get a guaranteed Sparking, you know, summon animation, you could get the new one, or you're gonna get one of the older ones, and there's a ton of them in there and everything like that. So again, we're not really sure. I did a video on this stuff, but basically I just kind of summed it up for you guys, okay? So obviously all this brand new stuff is coming. For anyone wondering about this stuff, this is just the thank you campaign, asking us to fill out some surveys and everything like that. I did a video on that where I translated everything if you did the Japanese version. So if you want to check the system a little bit, you can do both the global version on the JP on Facebook and then the JP one on Dokkan, and technically that will do more and more. I think on currently right now we're on step three, and then apparently I can't read. We're on step four right now. I don't know how much further we have to go. We got until the 11th, which is not until Friday. That says the 11th there. This is okay, so no matter what, until the 11th essentially, okay? So anyways, so all that stuff is going on, but the big thing just to take away from this is the fact that yes, we are having a maintenance tomorrow, and that's gonna give us a big update. So you're gonna have to update your app. There's probably gonna be a download, so we're gonna see what comes and everything. So keep an eye out on DBZ Space, keep an eye out on here on Twitter. I'll translate as much as I can. It is during work though when this will be happening, so if I can't, you know, automatically get to it right away, just know that I'm doing my other job, and then obviously I'll translate as soon as possible can, okay? So all that right there, that is official information that is from the Twitter page and everything like that. We're all good to go. Let's get into a little bit more stuff that is like about 95% confirmed, give or take, okay? And that is, of course, all about this year 5 stuff, okay? So this guy Omar, I don't really know him actually, he's been tweeting these pictures and everything like that, and there have been other pictures about this particular company right here that does these figures with the 300 million download celebration, with the year 4 celebration, with all this other stuff that relates to everything Dragon Ball with figures and everything. It's not just Dragon Ball, they don't with heroes and everything like that. But this whole rumor has been going around that, oh, Gogeta Blue is going to be the 5th year Dokkan Fest stuff. And, you know, and then they also had the one for, like, the Vegito Blue, the free-to-play STR Vegito Blue. But obviously, we're having that campaign start actually in a couple days here on the JP version of the game. So a lot of people are like, oh, we're going to be getting a new Vegito Blue and everything like that. But it's just simply the LR campaign for that. But now it looks like, again, not 100% confirmed or anything, but it would kind of make sense that in Nigatsu, this does say Nigatsu, Dokkan 5th anniversary, Super Saiyajin Goddo, Super Saiyajin Gogeta figure is coming out around here, which then obviously would mean that yes, in the game, we're supposed to be having a Super Saiyan Blue Gogeta. And if I had to take a wild guess, that probably also means that we are also going to get a Vegito Blue, because let's face it, every single year anniversary has been a dual Dokkan Fest. There's never been just simply one banner, okay? Now, if you do it, and then also he's, this picture's been going around, you know, the whole year one figure, year two, year three, year four, and there's obviously no Super Saiyan 5 canon. I know all about the fan-made stuff, but not canon stuff, okay? So what would be next? Well, naturally you would think God, and I guess you could technically do Super Saiyan God, Goku, and Vegeta, finally have a Dokkan Fest card for those two, or you're gonna go kind of a more hype, I guess? Maybe they'll introduce a new god, Goku and Vegeta, even though we have that Tech and STR one right now. But then that would basically mean that, oh, we're gonna get this Gogeta, because Super Saiyan Blue would be next, right? And I guess technically, yes, you could say that you could go Super Saiyan Blue Goku and Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta as the two. But if you think about it, year three was when we had the LR Vegito and Gogeta, the transformation units, right? And then year four here, which it seems like an eternity ago, but it really isn't that long ago, were the Super Saiyan 4 Goku and Vegeta LRs. Year 2 was obviously the reverse of these guys. So I'm going to call it, if this actually is a, you know, 100% true, all this stuff happens, all the figure stuff comes out. I mean, I'm assuming the figure stuff's going to come out no matter what, but all the figure stuff is related to the Dokkan collab and everything like that. I'm calling right now that the Gogeta Blue, okay, the Gogeta Blue will be int. He's going to be reverse of this guy. He's going to be an int card. And if there's a Vegito Blue, which would make sense because, again, dual Dokkan Fest, this guy will be physical, okay? I'm just calling it right now, which kind of sucks for this guy unless he's a transformation unit. If they're transformation units where it's Goku and Vegeta first and then they go Vegito and Gogeta, that's perfectly fine. If they start out as Vegito and Gogeta, though, that means that if the Vegito Blue is, again, going to be the opposite from the year three and it's going to be a physical unit, then if that OG physical Vegito Blue gets an EZA, you can't run them on the same team. So that's what I'm thinking. Again, thinking it's probably going to be Super Saiyan Blue, Goku, and Vegeta, which means you can obviously run them with other guards and everything like that that are separate. And then they'll fuse somehow into here. And, oh boy, okay, I have to put this question out now just because I love trolling about this stuff, okay? How bad do you think the transformation mechanics are going to be if, okay, again, and this is all big ifs, if this happens, if we get a Super Saiyan Blue, Goku, and Vegeta, one that will go into Gogeta and one that will go into Vegito, okay, how bad are the transformation mechanics going to be? How bad do you think they're going to be? Okay, let me know your thoughts all down in the comments below. Go crazy, guys, okay? We still got, oh man, it's already October. I mean, we got November, December, January, February. We got about 4 months until this stuff would even be out, okay? So if it's out, though, you got 4 months if you're seeing this video later on. Let me know how bad will the transformation mechanics be if, of course, they are going from a Super Saiyan Blue Goku and Vegeta combo and then going into a Gogeta form, okay? Which then, I guess, also begs the question, is it gonna, or would both of them basically be the same? Because these two you can run on their own because one's Super Saiyan and one's Angel Super Saiyan, but the Gogeta and Vegeta Blue combos, they've never gone Angels or anything like that. So maybe one's base and one's Super Saiyan Blue, and then they go like, I'm not really sure. I mean, otherwise you wouldn't be able to run them on the same team. So I don't know, maybe they'll change something up. Not really sure, but anyway, it is what it is. So, but yeah, anyway, so obviously Gogeta Blue would come, Vegeta Blue would probably come as well. And I mean, looking back at the year banners, and I know also there's been some figures for these guys, the AGL Super Saiyan 2 Angel Goku and the Majin Vegeta, who originally came out way back here. Man, that's, man, these cards were such a pain to pull. I'm sorry. If there are people that actually do want these cards, I'm sorry if you haven't been able to pull them or anything. But God, these cards just, every single summon, because they are featured with these guys. And you guys know my thoughts on LR banners and everything like that. But anyway, so there's also been some figure pictures that were leaked and everything like that when it came to these cards and everything. And a lot of people were thinking, oh, we're going to get a Majin Vegeta and a Super Saiyan 2 Goku, you know, dual Dokkan Fest stuff, and I guess that could possibly happen as well, but I think the more likely one is that, let's face it, Gogeta, Vegito are hype, right? No matter how long it's been, no matter if we've had these celebrations before or anything like that, those cards always bring people back, they always get people hyped up, and they're always really powerful, right? That's just the way it's always been, it's how it's always going to be. The fusions are some of the most popular characters in the entire Dragon Ball lore, and just within the fandom itself, okay? You can deny it all you want, but it is. What brings in more money? Would a Super Saiyan Angel Goku and a Majin Vegeta, two separate cards, or would fusions bring people back? You know, because obviously the year celebrations always bring people back when it comes to this kind of stuff. Some people are going to say they want the mods of Vegeta and Super Saiyan 2 Angel Goku, you know, more unique and new and stuff that we haven't seen before. That's totally fine to say. I'm not saying that your opinion is invalidated or anything like that. Just realistically, what brings more people back? Ultimate Fusions, right? Gogeta-Vegito combo. It's going to happen every single time, right? So you can say, oof, you can say yay, you can say whatever you want, but I don't know. We'll have to wait and see what's going to happen, okay? But my thoughts are that if those figures are now being shown, and to be, and, you know, obviously it was shown like, oh, maybe it is going to happen for the year 5 celebration or anything like that, then maybe what's going to happen is these guys get EZAs or something, right? It would make sense. These guys were from year 3. This was year 4, Dokkan Awakens, and then year 5, you know, again, EZAs or something like that. We'll have to wait and see. Or there could be new cards. I'm not really sure what's that's going to be. But basically, that's showing that year 3 was the Vegito-Gogeta combo. Year 4 was the same as year 2, basically, with the whole Super Saiyan 4s. And then year 5 would be obviously a Gogeta Blue, and obviously he's got to have a partner, which is going to be the Vegito Blue, okay? Now, some people will probably also say in the comment section below that, oh, well, maybe this means that we're going to see a Dragon Ball Super Broly? And that could totally happen too. We could see a Gogeta Blue banner, and we could see a Broly banner, right? To my knowledge, though, usually, and they can break the trends for this all you want. So again, let me hear your thoughts down below on this part is particularly well. But we've never had a hero, a villain separate banners for a year celebration. We've had tons of those for Golden Week and other celebrations and everything like that. But never for year celebrations, I think, except... Not even the Gogeta and Janemba, the OG year one cards, because Gogeta's banner... And then Janemba's banner had the physical Gotenks. That was when he first originally got released into the game. So I think that it is more likely that we're going to see Gogeta Blue and Vegeta Blue. If we do see Broly, that's fine, but they're not going to be, villain-only banners and hero-only banners. I could be wrong. I'm just taking a wild guess here. Again, like I said, none of this is 100% confirmed, but with all the pictures that are flying around and everything like that, and then the past couple of months where it comes to other figures and the Super Saiyan Blue collaboration and the campaign and everything like that, you know, it would make sense that this would happen, right? Obviously, God, I don't think God is enough to bring more people back. What is? Well, Super Saiyan Blue, right? Super Saiyan Blue Gogeta was phenomenal in the movie and brought a lot of hype and everything like that. Vegeta Blue's had hype around him ever since he originally appeared, and people have always wanted him to come back. So, what better way to do that? So, anyway, I'm going to stop rambling, guys. You let me know your thoughts down in the comments. Do you think that a Vegeta Blue, Gogeta Blue combination is going to come? Do you think they're going to be fused already? Think they're going to be separate and then fuse? And, of course, let me know. I want to see these crazy predictions that people are going to have. If they are separate Goku and Vegeta, what kind of transformation mechanics do you think they're going to have? So, anyway, guys, that's going to be it for the video. Let me hear your thoughts down below in the comments, as always. Leave a like if you like the video. Subscribe if you happen to be new. We're trying to hit 75,000 subs by the end of 2019. So make sure you go ahead and hit that sub button if you haven't already. Join the international family and hit the notification buttons as well if you want to be updated on all things, okay? By the way, I guess we'll be seeing the Easy Area stuff coming soon. So within the next day or so, you'll be seeing that, and I'll be translating all that stuff as well, okay? Anyway, that's going to be it for the video, guys. Until next time, everyone, I will see you all in the next one.